Yesterday, 42 more people lost their lives. Illinois' seven-day case positivity rate continues to hold at 2.4%. Across Illinois, more than 93,000 vaccine doses were administered on Wednesday. Nearly 3 million doses have been administered statewide. 7.5% of the state's population is fully vaccinated. 17% of people have had at least one shot.
Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Some people are having some skin reactions. What's going on there? Is that potentially a big issue?
Well, it's not a big issue. It's less than 1%, and it's pretty much limited to people that take the Moderna vaccine, and more women than men are getting these reactions. The strange thing is they're appearing like 7 to 10 days after the vaccine is administered. Typically, the rashes and other things that you get around the injection site in your shoulder occur pretty quickly. So this is kind of an odd reaction that's occurring later. It goes away, it's not an infection. It's minor. It doesn't limit you from getting your second shot. Matter of fact, after the second shot, the rate actually goes down. It's just a strange phenomenon.
Dr. Fauci was talking yesterday here in Chicago, said vaccines might not completely end the worries of COVID-19. I think people wonder about that going forward. What are your thoughts?
Well, I think it's what he is saying is this is going to be end up like an epidemic. That's more like the influenza epidemic, where the vaccine will keep changing every year. You'll still be required to take the vaccine. You're going to have boosters. In other words, it's just not going to go away.
All right, let's take a look at some viewer questions. My wife had the first Moderna vaccine yesterday. She has a history of allergies and carries Benadryl and an EpiPen. After about 10 minutes, she started having a reaction in her airway and broke out in hives. We administered Benadryl. We read online preservatives may have been the cause. Can she take the Johnson & Johnson vaccine if a booster is required in the future?
Well, this is not anaphylaxis, but this is a serious reaction. And most likely she should not take the Moderna vaccine again. She should take something else. I think the Johnson & Johnson vaccine would be a good choice. That's what I would recommend. But, you know, that's up to her and her doctor.
All right, next question. We've seen coverage on a drug called ivermectin that sounds like a game changer in the COVID fight. Why isn't this in use? We wouldn't need a vaccine. What is that?
Well, there's two things about this question. One is ivermectin is an old drug, been around for a long time, treats of weird diseases, unusual tropical type diseases. And, it like hydroxychloroquine, like lopinavir, like interferon, all these old drugs that they tried to recycle to treat COVID. You know, where did all that go? There was all this hype and the government was buying millions of pills and whatever. You know, when you do the big clinical trials, it just doesn't pan out. I mean, I just don't see it being the game changer. However, the point is, there are a couple of drugs out there that, and there'll be more forthcoming, that are what they call direct-acting antiviral drugs that really will work against the SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID. So those are coming down the pike right now. There's two companies that are testing drugs right now. And if you know about Tamiflu and flu, you know that drug, I think there'll be some type of treatment like that in the next few months.
All right, next question. What is Dr. Murphy's prediction for the Brazilian crisis and how can the global community provide aid?
Yeah, this is, I mean, Brazil is in a real crisis. I mean, not only is the pandemic completely out of control in Brazil, but they're getting variants that are really more lethal. I mean, it is dangerous down there. It's really sad. For Brazil, I mean, many things can be done, but before anybody pumps, huge amounts of money in there to try to fix the structural problems, you have to get rid of the leadership. I mean, the leadership has to change. It's in conflict with the public health needs.
All right, we'll see what happens. Lastly, we got this photo from Amanda. She says, my baby focuses in on Dr. Murphy and stops playing to listen to him every morning.
Huh.
Wow, you're luring in the young demo.
Yeah, she's got to bring the average down, you know?
Look at that. Mesmerizing.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yeah, maybe you can work in some balloon animals on Monday.
What's my daughter's name, Amanda?
All right, Dr. Murphy, thanks again. If you have a question for the doctor, post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Have a good weekend.
It would be great if he could.